Hello everyone, welcome to chemistry classes. So in the previous session we have discussed about electrochemistry. What is electrochemistry? So what are the basic chemical reactions taking place in the electrochemistry? So those are none other than redox reactions. Okay, so now we'll discuss about what is exact meaning of electrochemistry and why we have to study the electrochemistry. And to study electrochemistry, what are the few more basic components we should understand? Okay, so now let's start with electrochemistry. So let us define electrochemistry. So here, this electrochemistry, it is a branch of chemistry. Electrochemistry is the branch of chemistry which deals with study of production of electricity, which deals with the study of production of electricity from the energy released during spontaneous chemical reaction. So once again I'll repeat, electrochemistry is the branch of chemistry which deals with the study of production of electricity. The production of electricity means what? The preparation of electricity from the energy. By using which energy? From the energy released during spontaneous chemical reaction. So I think you all of you are aware about that. If a spontaneous chemical reaction takes place, spontaneous means what? A chemical reaction which takes place on its own is called as spontaneous chemical reaction. If a spontaneous chemical reaction takes place, then what happens? In a spontaneous chemical reaction, some amount of energy is released. So that released energy is called as Gibbs free energy, isn't it? So that released energy or Gibbs energy can be converted into electrical energy. So the production of electricity by using the Gibbs free energy or the energy released in our spontaneous chemical reaction. So in our electrochemistry, we will deal with the conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy, the meaning of that. Next, and it continues, there is another part, use of electricity. Electricity means electrical energy. Use of electricity to bring about non-spontaneous chemical reaction. So non-spontaneous chemical reaction means what? The chemical reaction which do not take place on its own. For the performance of that chemical reaction, we have to add some external agents or external energies required for those reaction. The chemical reaction which does not occur on its own is called as a non-spontaneous chemical reaction. So by using electrical energy, we can bring about non-spontaneous chemical reaction. We can make non-spontaneous chemical reaction to occur. So here, these two types of studies are there in electrochemistry. So simply, this electrochemistry gives the interconversion of electrical energy into chemical energy as well as chemical energy into electrical energy. Okay? See, so here, electrochemistry topic alli yen martivi andre naavu mainly erdu kelasana martivi athwa erdu kelasana study martivi yen antandre conversion of electrical energy into chemical energy and conversion of chemical energy into electrical energy. See, so here, now spontaneous chemical reaction tagalkondivi antandre spontaneous means what? ಯಾವ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ತನ್ನಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ತಾನೇ ಆಗುತ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ಏನ್ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ನಾವು ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಆ ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುವ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಎನರ್ಜಿನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ನಾವು? ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ದ ಕನ್ವರ್ಷನ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ, ದ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ದಿಂದ ಬಂದಂತ ಎನರ್ಜಿಯನ್ನು ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿಯನ್ನು ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಹೌದಾ? ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆನೂ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಏನು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವಲ್ಲಿ ದ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ದ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ತನ್ನಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ತಾನೇ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಹೌದಾ? ಆ ತರದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ಆ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗೋ ತರ ಆಗೋತರ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವ ತರ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿನ ಕೊಟ್ಟಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಈ ನಾವು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಪಾಂಟೇನಿಯಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸಿ ಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ದ ವರ್ಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋ, ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋ ದಟ್ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ದಟ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ವಿತ್ ಇಂಟರ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೀಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಅಂಡ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಬ್ರೀಫ್ಲಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದೆಮ್. ಸಿಯರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟರ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ಅಂಡ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೀಲಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೀಲಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿವೈಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್, ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲ್ವನಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ ವೋಲ್ಟಾಯಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್. ಗ್ಯಾಲ್ವನಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ ವೋಲ್ಟಾಯಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಲ್ವನಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ ವೋಲ್ಟಾಯಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ನೇಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೆಮ್, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಲೈಟಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಂಟು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ. ಸಿಯರ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್, ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಕರಿಂಗ್, ಸಾರಿ ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಕರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ E stands for electrical energy and C stands for chemical energy. So electrical energy to chemical energy, isn't it? You can remember very much easily. So it is a device in which non-spontaneous chemical reaction is taking place by the use of electric current. So it is called as electrolytic cell. Once again I'll repeat. The non-spontaneous chemical reaction takes place by using electrical energy. So this device is called as electrolytic cell, or simply you can define a device in which electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. That is called as electrolytic cell. In electrolytic cell, the process taking place is called as electrolysis. So about that we'll discuss subsequently. Electrolytic cell. So in electrolytic cell, mainly which reaction takes place? Non-spontaneous chemical reaction takes place. So non-spontaneous means what? The chemical reaction do not takes place on its own, but it can be performed by utilizing some external energies like electrical energy. For non-spontaneous chemical reaction, delta G is equals to positive. Delta G is greater than zero. Delta G means what? It is gives free energy. So for non-spontaneous chemical reaction, delta G is positive, or it is greater than zero. Please remember this thing also. And next, another cell or another device is galvanic cell, or it is also called as voltaic cell. There is another name for them. What is that? Electrochemical cell. They are also called as electrochemical cell. So opposite of this, electrochemical cells are opposite of electrolytic cell. Here in electrolytic cell, electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. So opposite, the chemical energy is converted into electrical energy in this cell. So chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. Here electrical energy is converted into chemical energy. So the chemical energy is converted into electrical energy means what? In this cell, in this device, which reaction takes place? Spontaneous chemical reaction takes place. So in this galvanic cell, spontaneous chemical reaction takes place. Okay, so then what do you mean by spontaneous? A chemical reaction which takes place on its own. It do not require any external agents for the performance. Okay, For this spontaneous chemical reaction, delta G is equals to negative. Please remember, delta G means what? Delta G is gives free energy for spontaneous chemical reaction is less than zero or it is negative. Less than zero or negative. So now, by combining all these, we can define galvanic cell. So galvanic cell is a device which converts chemical energy of a spontaneous chemical reaction into electrical energy. Okay, it's very much simple definition. So galvanic cell is a device which converts chemical energy of a spontaneous chemical reaction into what? Electrical energy. Okay, so I hope all of you understood about these things. And to study electrochemistry effectively, we require two more basic components. The first one is electrode. What do you mean by electrode? See here, electrode means it is a combination or interface formed by a metal which is dipped in the solution of its own ions. The electrode means a metal which is dipped in a solution of its own ions is called as electrode. See here, for example, if I take copper sulfate solution in a beaker, copper sulfate solution, this copper sulfate solution contains Cu2 plus ions as well as SO4 2 minus ions. In this solution, if I dip this copper rod here, I will place copper metal into this solution. Now this combination is called as copper electrode. Now we can call it as copper electrode because the copper metal is in contact with a solution. This solution contains its ions, the metal ions. Metal is in contact with its metal ions is called as electrode. So now it is our copper electrode. And there are two type of electrodes. The electrodes are simply named as cathode and anode. So till now you used to define cathode and anode in one way. Now onwards you have to define cathode and anode in another way. So that is cathode, it is an electrode at which reduction reaction takes place. Please remember, it's very simple. Cathode is an electrode where the reduction reaction takes place. In our cell, if reduction reaction takes place, that electrode should be called as a cathode. Anode means what? Here the reduction takes place. Here what should take place? Oxidation. Here the oxidation takes place. An electrode at which oxidation reaction takes place is called as an anode. So we should remember cathode and anode on the basis of reduction and oxidation. So till now you have remembered cathode and anode on the basis of their sign, plus and minus. So now also we use plus and minus, as well as it's more important than the signs, which are those, the reduction and oxidation reactions. Okay, I hope all of you understood about this. Okay, if you find this video is helpful for you, please like, comment and share among your friends, and please don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching.